joined now by Tom Wilson as we continue to unpack the journey, the ride, the experience that was 17-18 and the resulting Stanley Cup playoffs, culminating obviously with the hoisting of the cup. And Tom, when you look at it, I mean, how do you try to capture all of that so that 30, 40 years from now when you guys are doing the reunion tour, you do remember those things? And what are the things that you really want to hold on to, the images and the memories?
Yeah, we're fortunate, fortunate and unfortunate of the media coverage, you know, with our celebrations. And hopefully Instagram and Twitter and all that never goes anywhere, because in 30 years you'll be able to just open who knows what and look back on those times. But there's not one moment that will ever, I don't think, really stand out. It was the entire thing, you know, sharing it with the boys in Vegas and coming home and sharing it with the city and everyone that, you know, supported you. And this group's so fun. I think we might be having like a 5-year reunion and like maybe a 10, 15, 20, I don't know. So it's going to be fun whenever this group gets back together.
Do you feel like you have a greater appreciation now for that? And is that something that you think can propel you guys to another one of these at some point?
Yeah, thinking back on it, I mean, it feels like Columbus, and, you know, it feels like that was so long ago. Mm-hmm. It feels like we've played almost in another kind of whole season. After every single day in the playoffs, you're mentally completely dialed in. There's no breaks, even on an off day. You're doing whatever you can to make yourself feel better for the next game. So it can be draining. I believe it's extremely hard to win. There's great players that never even had a chance. So it's a huge privilege, and I think you do get hungrier and hungrier as the series, and as you get closer to your goal, you definitely get hungrier. You start to taste it. In round one, it seems a little bit distant, but round three, you're like, all right, we're almost, like, we can keep doing this. So it's, you know, we're definitely have an appreciation for it. We've learned a lot. Everyone in that room, I think, will have a good understanding on what's going to help future teams that they play on get to where they want to be again.
We talked, there's a lot of people who would point back to the beginning of the season and say, yeah, no one gave us much of a chance, or, you know, maybe they had us in the playoffs, but not getting this far. And then you go into the playoffs and knock off the number one, number three, number five offensive teams in the season. You beat four really good goaltenders, four pretty good coaches, and some really good talented teams. How did you get so far so fast?
We had wake-up calls throughout the year. We had guys going down with injury. We had guys stepping up. And you know what? It's all goes into it. And when you get to the playoffs, you know, those games are hard. You know, we're down two right out of the gate. I was just watching some recap videos in there, and it's unbelievable kind of the perseverance that our group had. And I think there's not one day that I can think back that, you know, the next morning this team didn't have fun. Even when we got lost 5-0 to anyone, you know, we wake up the next morning, we learn from it, but we get out on the ice and, you know, we'd start to laugh and we'd start to have fun again. And it was just a group that we knew when it was business time, and we knew when it was time that we could keep it light. And we're playing soccer before game three of the Columbus series, and guys are just howling, laughing. So I don't know if that's professional. I don't know if that goes into, maybe is that the right recipe? I don't know, but it worked for us.
Having won the cup now, what do you do with your day with it?
Over the years since I got drafted, I've pulled a lot of as many Leaf fans as I can onto the Caps bandwagon. So there's definitely going to be some red in Toronto. And obviously that city wants the cup pretty bad. So I'm assuming it's going to be a little bit crazy at certain points. But there will definitely be a time for family. There will be a little bit of time for public and for meaningful causes, or hopefully just do whatever I can with the one day that I get it.
We look forward to that. We look forward to September when we see you back here for the defense of that cup.